Their world was one of violence and religious oppression, political corruption, and social upheaval. Armed conflict was common, and dictators seemed to rule the day. After 2,000 years, it seems as if our world hasn't changed very much.
Into a dark world, God chose to reveal himself in the most unlikely way, through a small, helpless baby. And he chose an even more unlikely messenger, a young teenage girl named Mary from the town of Nazareth.
Even though Mary could have felt embarrassed or even ashamed when she became pregnant before being married, she chose to believe that the angel Gabriel had told her months before, "Don't be frightened, Mary, for God has decided to bless you. You will become pregnant and have a son, and you are to name him Jesus. He will be very great and will be called the Son of the Most High."
What life-changing news for a teenage girl. Surely, she must have felt confused, anxious, even excited. Yet Mary also found a place deep inside her heart where she made peace with what was to happen. And from that place of peace, her joy began to grow and grow until she could no longer contain it.
What?
that it doesn't make sense to the world because it's not of this world. A peace that passes all understanding. As adults, we have our relaxation techniques, our self-help books, and our 10 easy steps to less stress in 10 minutes. What we don't always have is peace in our lives. And sometimes it takes a little child to show us the way.
Thank you.
throughout the Roman Empire. All returned to their own towns to register for the census. And because Joseph was a descendant of King David, he had to go to Bethlehem in Judea, David's ancient home. He traveled there from the village of Nazareth in Galilee. He took with him Mary, his fiancée, who was great with child by this time.
And while they were there, the time came for her baby to be born. She gave birth to her first child, a son. She wrapped him snugly in strips of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the village inn. That night, some shepherds were in the field outside the village, guarding their flocks of sheep.
Suddenly, an angel of the Lord appeared among them, and the radiance of the Lord's glory surrounded them. They were terrified.
we have taken an offering during the intermission with Cantata to benefit the Ministry of Love, Inc., which we all know of and know of the great things that Love, Inc. does in the community, and also help to defray the expenses of the community choir. So our ushers will come forward and take this offering. When they get up front here, we'll have prayer. And then during the offertory, we are very pleased to be able to enjoy the beautiful musical artistry of Mary Hendershot on the flute. She will be playing What Child Is This? Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the privilege of coming and performing this cantata today. We thank you for your holy word on which this is based. We thank you for the Lord Jesus Christ, without whom we would not be celebrating this season or have any reason to celebrate at all. Lord, we pray that you would bless this offering to its intended purpose for Love, Inc. and the community chorus. And we pray that everything said and done here today will bring glory to your holy name. And we ask this in Jesus' name.
disturbed by their question, as was all of Jerusalem. They called a meeting of the leading priests and teachers of religious law. Where did the prophets say the Messiah would be born? He asked them. In Bethlehem, they said, for this is what the prophet wrote. Then Herod sent a private message to the wise men, asking them to come and see him. At this meeting, he learned the exact time when they first saw the star. Then he told them, go to Bethlehem and search carefully for the child. And when you find him, come back and tell me them so that I can go worship him too.
After this interview, the wise men went on their way. Once again, the star appeared to them, guiding them to Bethlehem. It went ahead of them and stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were filled with joy. They entered the house where the child and his mother Mary were. They fell down before him and worshiped him. Then they opened their treasure chests and gave him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Gifts, yet surely they received far more than they gave. How years ago, you came into this world and into our lives to bridge the gap, to make right the relationship between you and humanity through your Son, Jesus. And because of his sacrifice, we can know eternal peace with you. How we praise you and love you. We thank you for the gift of your Spirit, the Comforter, who lives in our hearts, who encourages us and guides us back to you when we lose our way. And we celebrate that we are unique expressions of your love to the world, demonstrating the way of peace to all. Amen.
Just like clockwork, ready or not, Christmas arrives every year. We expect a lot from this time of year, and our expectations often go unfulfilled. Maybe next year things will be different, we tell ourselves. Maybe then we'll feel the spirit of Christmas in our hearts. Truth be told, some of us leave Christmas in the manger all year long, yet miss out on the power and the presence of the risen Christ in our lives.
A famous songwriter wrote an anthem for peace many years ago called Imagine. We don't have to simply imagine what a peaceful world is like. We have that available through the power of Christ's Spirit at any time, at any place. Make this year the year you take the baby Jesus out of the manger and receive him into your heart and life.
You can change your own little part of the world by simply abiding in Christ's joy and peace. Be the change you want to see. Receive his unconditional love and experience a peace that the world cannot give. For once you know the child of peace, his kingdom of peace will appear. First in your heart, and in the hearts of everyone you touch.
How many times have you thought during this season already, I just would like a little peace and quiet? Well, we hope this afternoon you've got a little bit the message, the beautiful message from God's Word. He is a child of peace. Peace that passes all understanding is available to us when we know Him, when we allow Him to come into our hearts and into our lives. What a marvelous word, His peace. We think about peace all over the world, and we need some peace in some embattled areas of the world. But we also need peace in the embattled areas of our own personal lives. And that's where Christ does so much when we open up to Him. And our prayer for you, for each of us this afternoon, is that you, along with us, allow the child of peace, Jesus, fill your heart and your life today, all during this season, and all year long, we pray. Oh God, you have offered us peace. Jesus told us that in the world we'd have trials and tribulations, but we could be of good cheer, for you'd overcome the world. And you offer us peace. Lord, in these moments, we want to just rest in your peace. May we, each one of us here, be able to focus our hearts and our minds on you, Lord. Take a deep breath. And allow your peace to fill our hearts. May we go from this place full of the child of peace. And may we go with the conviction that this is the peace we want to share with all the world around us. The peace of God. The peace of Christ. The peace of His Spirit. We pray in the precious and powerful name of the Child of Peace, Jesus Christ our Savior.
Thank you.